Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to do a warm-up prep and also some plyometric exercises. All right, we're going to focus on knees, groin, and lateral movements. Today we're working with professional athlete Tarik Black. As you can see, we like to start out on the ground where we're doing some hamstring floss, but what this is going to also do is get some synovial joint fluid going in that knee, but also get the quads to get a good pump in them. All right, so we're going to spend about 30 or 60 seconds here. I made him go 60 seconds on each side. Next up, we got into these banded knee extensions, except I'm making him do an isometric contraction. So I'm just asking for him to get a lot of recruitment inside of that quad muscle as that band is pulling him forward. Make sure you select a band that you're able to do. He's been doing that for a while, so green is one of the toughest resistance. So go lighter until you get it, all right? Next up, similar exercise to a Spanish squat. Also going back into knee extension, but now the band is more decelerating him forward as he comes into that squat. So now this has a deceleration component rather than just doing knee extensions. We're getting him prepped for whenever we're about to start doing our plyometric exercises. So try this one out. Go into extension, come back down, let that band pull you, stop that deceleration, and pause for a second. Next, we have a little bit of freedom on this other side. So you really have to stabilize on the leg that's on the black box. All right, we got flexion at the hip, knee, and at the ankle. Politely tap that turf. Don't put a lot of weight on the ground. And this is going to get a really good burn in that leg. All right, don't skip this one. We're prepped, now it's time to get active. So I'm not looking for him to have extreme air time here. What I'm looking for is rhythm and pace. So look at his back foot. He's getting some ankle stability work down there, some big toe mobility, but the main focus is rhythm and pace because we're about to get ready to jump. Next, we have these single leg hops. Don't sleep on these. A lot of people don't feel like they're beneficial, but this is actually good for rhythm and strength and also building endurance. All right, getting ready for the court if you were to have a game. Here, I'm just asking for him to find a good rhythm and a pace to stick with for at least 20 seconds or so. Next, we change the direction in which we jump. Whenever we're playing a sport, we want to focus on ankle inversion, eversion, and also acceleration. These are the movements that's likely going to take place on the field or on the court, whatever sport you may play. Also, this will provide a different feel than going forward as far as the stability and the balance when you land onto that black box. You'll notice that it may be less difficult or more difficult depending on where your ankle stability and balance has been challenged. And not only is it challenging your ankle stability, but it's also beneficial for your knee and your hip as you go through these different directions. I know it's not a super flashy drill, but it really can help enhance and improve your single leg capabilities. So get used to doing simple exercises or what may seem simple because they are beneficial for you. All right, the next drill that we get into is more so skills. It's mimicking his sport. So he's going to do a small hop into a lateral bound and then explode from there onto the box. So now we're going for timing, we're going for speed, and we're going for more explosiveness, fighting against that resistance band. If you pay attention to him, watch his tempo. So he's gonna go small, explode, small, explode. I want you to really focus on that small hop and then give me a really big push to that black box. Challenge yourself on this one as far as distance. After he finished those, we went into more of a sports-like movement. So as you can see, he's stabilizing on one leg, and after he slams, I want a lateral push. It's also good to challenge your skill set under fatigue. How well are you conditioned to do a drill? So after you finish this, you're going to take a big rest break, and we got one more plyometric drill to do. It's fourth quarter now, so I'm asking for him to get some height. Rather than going for a skill, I'm just looking for him to give me a push and jump as high as he can, absorb the force of that ground, and repeat. You're going 4 and 4 here. We're not looking to burn yourself out because you're already extremely tired. So make sure that you're focusing on getting good quality reps as you finish out this drill, because the next one, I'm going to fatigue you out. So I want the band around your hips. The cones are 10 feet apart. Every time you go back to the first cone, that's a rep. We went for 4 here. I want you to do them as quickly as you possibly can. Okay, so go for conditioning here. You're gonna get a good lung burn, and you're gonna flip right on the other side, no break. You'll only get a break once you finish out this drill. All right, guys, so thank you so much for watching. This is going to conclude what I'm going to show you for today. We did do a lift after this, but I wanted to show you guys more of the plyometrics, the knee warm-ups, and things that we like to do. All right, leave some comments and let me know how I can help further. Thank you.